Welcome back. Not only are fuchsias hardy little flowers, but they come in a rainbow of gorgeous colors. Gardening wizard Cisco Morris is here with secrets to making them thrive. Come on out, Cisco. Woo, here he comes. And he's here. So you brought an amazing array. These are hardy, you say. They're survivors.
These all come back every year. This one, and look at the size of the flower on this guy.
So pretty.
This is Delta's groom. Oh my gosh, and hummingbirds go nuts over this. They fight over each blossom.
That is beautiful. I love the fact that they all have two colors, too.
Me too.
So they're really interesting looking.
And they bloom all summer. They start in May, and they keep blooming until after Thanksgiving most of the time.
Why don't I have more of these? Let's start on this end and tell us about the different varieties that you brought, because you have lots of different
things. This is Queen Esther, and it used to only be in hanging baskets.
Then
somebody decided to plant one in their garden and see what happened, and it came back every year. So they said, all right, we're going to call it a hardy fuchsia, and these need more sun.
Okay.
So you got to
plant. I have just the place for those.
Oh, yeah. You don't want to against a south wall, but a lot of sun.
Yeah.
Look at the size of these blooms.
These are amazing, too.
This is something or other.
Go into Swanson's and ask him for the lady something or other,
Boothby.
Man.
Lady Boothby, but you know what the problem is with this? It grows 14 feet tall.
That's a problem? That seems good.
Oh, it's really cool, but you got to tie it up somehow. When they get 14 feet, they start going
just
like this.
Just get a stake and let them go.
Yeah,
but those are big old flowers in the red and purple.
And this is Aztec here with these big, big flowers, you know. And
all right, what about these guys? They look a little like the first
ones. This is called Erecta, and it's one of the first ones where the flowers stick upward.
Oh.
So you can look right into the flower, and the hummingbirds are nuts this guy right
here. That's true, because the rest of them are dropping down a little bit, which is part of their beauty. This one, too, everybody will love these. Very simple pink things.
This is a really gorgeous one. And this is Debron's smoky blue. So there's a lot of kinds of these, you know, that are just so
cool. You can see it in the front, the dark pink and the light pink when it grows. Now, are all of these in the sunshine?
These are all in sunshine.
Everybody.
If they aren't, they'll survive, but they won't bloom very well.
And what would be the point? We want them to
look at this, Debron's dark chocolate.
Look at that. Look at the tiny, tiny little buds that come out on those.
Yeah, and they just keep, and you know what's cool? You don't have to take off the spent flowers.
You don't.
They just fall
I was just
off.
About to ask. You don't have to prune during the flowering season. Just let them go.
Nope, and you know what else is really cool about them is that they get berries, and you can eat them. They're really high in vitamin C. And there's not one kind of poison fuchsia that I've ever been able to find out about. But if you buy a new fuchsia and you plant it, nobody knows you're going to eat the berries. So you got to grow it for 2 years before you start nibbling on the berries.
Okay, because you never know what's up.
In more trouble.
Yeah, just, you know what, maybe just be careful with that. What's this guy?
This is Debron's mystery plant because I lost the tag and I can't remember what it is. But it's going to be a good one.
Oh, the info you get here. Okay, so if I'm going to plant these, if I don't have one already, now I know where my sunniest spot is in the yard, how do I plant them? What's the best way?
Here's the interesting thing. If, like this this one right here, Delta's Groom, it's only hardy to zone 8. It's not as hardy as some of the other ones.
Okay.
So,
well, you know I need the toughest one you've got.
Yep, but if you wanted to grow this, you'd have to plant it 4 inches deeper than it came in the pot. And that protects the roots down there.
Am I going to get all those instructions? Just ask the nursery?
Yeah, you can ask the nursery person, you know. But the rest of these, really, unless you live in a really cool place, you could plant them right at ground level, just at the height they came out of the pot, and they come back. The one thing you want, not baking hot sun, but a nice sunny spot with well-drained soil.
Okay.
You know,
so if I'm not sure about my soil, how big of a hole do I dig and what do I put in it?
Okay. You know, that's a funny thing. If you have, let's say, clay soil, you know, you dig and your the pick hits the ground and you fly in the air.
That's not good.
If you have that kind of soil, you're not going to be able to grow these unless you make some kind of a raised bed to grow them on. Because when you dig into clay, even though you replace with good soil and everything,
all the water just runs right in there, and it's a bathtub.
So maybe a raised bed or something like that would work?
A raised bed would work fantastic.
That would be beautiful with these. What do they look like in the winter?
They get sort of ugly. They drop all their leaves, and they're just the sticks.
But don't worry about it. They're going to come back.
And then in spring, just keep watching, because you're like, oh, no, did it die? You know? And then you see new growth right at the base.
Wow.
So you cut all those old sticks right down to the new growth. Because
only when the new growth comes.
Because the thing about these is all of the flowers occur as it grows. So you can let them get 12 feet tall, but if you do, not all of them get that tall, but if you do, all the flowers are going to be way at the top and way out here because all the growth was way out there instead of starting from the
bottom.
That
makes sense. And can we plant them now?
You could plant them right now. And I just wanted to show you, this is, so there's ones with really little flowers. They call them ladies' eardrops.
Ladies' eardrops.
Yeah, and this is Orium with golden foliage. But these get 12 feet tall. I saw these kind when I was hiking in Chile. Hummingbirds all over them. It's so fun. They were almost 20 feet tall in Chile.
So, that's amazing.
Yeah, golden foliage, pretty cool. I mean, there's so many kinds of these. Everybody should have at least 42 in their garden.
42.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just short, I think 41. So it's going to be super hot, obviously, for us.
Oh, yeah.
And it's hot all over the country in a really serious way. What is it we should be thinking about with our gardens to make sure our plants don't suffer too much?
You really want to water. Keep an eye on your plants. Mm-hmm. Everything does. I mean, if you've got lavender, it's not going to care. It's going to love the heat.
Yeah.
But if you've got some of these flowering fuchsias and things, they might need a drink of water. So watch for things wilting.
Okay.
And here's something that'll surprise the livid tweet a lot of people. And that is if you've got these at home and you're waiting to plant them in the morning right away. Because once they're in the ground, you'll have to keep them well watered. But they'll do a lot better. You leave these in the pot sitting in your driveway.
Ooh.
At least put them in the shade. Because you're
going
to have to water these three times a day to keep them going, you know.
That's a good thought. So get those and get them in the ground right away. Oh, these are beautiful. I'm so glad you told us about these.
Yeah,
I'm going to add a few. Thank you so much.